You wear cotton clothes during summer, woolen clothes during winter. Now, do you ever wonder where we get this cotton and wool from? Cotton is obtained from special cotton plants which are grown. They are in the form of cotton balls, which are extracted and then processed. So these cotton plants in the form of cotton balls, they're extracted and processed to get cotton. Similarly, wool. Wool, you know, we get from sheep. So from the rearing of sheep, we get wool. Now, there are special organisms, that is these worms known as silk worms, from which we get silk. You must have seen silk. You wear silk clothes, silk curtains and so on. This silk is obtained from the worms known as silk worms. So all these fibers that we just saw, that is cotton, wool and silk, we obtain from natural sources. So these fibers are known as natural fibers. But nowadays, we are able to synthesize fibers. Some fibers can be synthesized in the laboratory from some special compounds and by some special techniques. It is now possible to synthesize fibers in the laboratory. These fibers that can be artificially synthesized are known as synthetic or man-made fibers. These fibers can be synthesized in the laboratory from some special chemicals. Since they can be artificially synthesized, they are known as synthetic or man-made fibers. For example, rayon. Rayon is obtained from wood pulp, but after obtaining it, we have to carry out some reactions. So rayon is considered to be a semi-synthetic fiber. It is neither a truly synthetic fiber nor a natural one. So rayon, we obtain from wood pulp and then we have to carry out some chemical reactions. So it is considered to be a semi-synthetic fiber. And rayon is used for making a number of different articles. For example, it is used in making bed sheets, for making rayon carpets and so on. Another fiber that you must have heard of is nylon. Nylon is obtained from coal, water and air. It was first synthesized in 1931. Nylon is the first truly synthetic fiber. Another property of nylon is that it is elastic and light, and it is lustrous and easy to wash. These properties of nylon are used in making a number of different articles. For example, it is used in making socks, curtains, and even parachutes. It is known that nylon threads are even stronger than steel wires. A nylon thread is stronger than even a steel wire, and this property of nylon enables it to form parachutes. Another important fibers that we use today are polyester and acrylic. These fibers have the important properties that they do not wrinkle fast and they are easy to wash. So nowadays, many dresses that you see are made up of polyester. For example, these jerseys that you see, they have a shiny look, easy to wash, and they do not wrinkle fast. So they are made up of polyester. Polyester is also used for making the PET jars that we used to store things in the kitchen. So even they are made up of polyester. And acrylic? Acrylic has a woolen kind of appearance. So they're used for making sweaters. They're not exactly woolen sweaters that we wear, but they have the look, the appearance of the woolen sweater that are used. So acrylic fibers are used for making sweaters. Now, you must have heard that we should never wear synthetic clothes in kitchen. So synthetic clothes in kitchen, they should always be avoided. Because one very important property of the synthetic fibers is that they are highly combustible. They easily catch fire. And so, it should always be avoided. We should never wear synthetic fibers in the kitchen. Now, how do we get these synthetic or artificial fibers? These fibers are actually long chains of molecules. These long chain of molecules we call polymers. Polymer comes from two words. Poly means many and meros means parts. So polymer actually means when one unit, which we call monomer, so one unit, it keeps on repeating, forming a very long chain. So such a unit, which keeps on repeating, is known as a monomer. Mono means one. So when one unit or one molecule, it comes together, it forms a very long chain that we call a polymer. Poly means many. So when many monomers come together, they form a polymer. So a polymer can be in different forms. It can be a single long chain. It can be a branched chain. The branches can be in different forms. So whenever a monomer forms chains, long chains in different forms, it forms straight long chains or branched long chains. These long chains we call polymers. And these are the polymers which are used in making the artificial or the synthetic fibers. So how do we get these artificial, synthetic or the man-made fibers? They are made up of polymers. And polymers are long chain of monomers. Monomer is the repeating unit. When this monomer repeats and it forms a long chain, whether a straight chain or a branch chain, we get a polymer. And these polymers are used for making synthetic or man-made fibers.